Hello friends, welcome again, and this is my new project, Student Information System, and I have developed this project in Python, Django and MySQL. The version for Python I am using is the Python version 2.7 and the Django version is 1.11 and the MySQL version is 5.6. For connecting the MySQL with the Python, I am using the MySQL Python connector, and you will get it easily from the mysql.org website. Okay, so for fronting, I am using the basic HTML, CSS and JavaScript, jQuery library for direct form validations and the data integrations. So this is all about the front-end technology, back-end technology and the client-side scripting languages. So the project title is Student Information System, and it's a mini project which contains the functionality about to manage the information of the students. That's it. So in this project, there is an admin login, and admin can login and manage the information of the students. So this is all about the project. So let's start. So this is the home page of the project. So you can see this is the home page, and the information of this page is all is static and nothing is dynamic in this page. Okay, this is the about project. So the information of this page is also static. There is nothing coming from the database. This is the contact us page, and this is also a static page, and I am not saving the information of this contact us anywhere in the database. This is the admin login, and this is a dynamic page, and the login information of the admin is getting verified from the database. So if you enter the invalid credential, then you will not be able to log inside the admin panel. So the user ID is admin and the password is test. So once you log inside the system, then you can see the dashboard for the admin, and admin can perform only these operations because the module which is available in this project only for these record things, right? So this is the add student, this is student details and the change password. So this is the add student, this is the add student page from where admin will be able to enter the information of the student. Also, admin will be able to choose the photo of the student and can upload. Right. So if you click on the submit, then you can see the validations are has already been available in the form, and without entering the proper information, you will not be able to saving the information. One more thing I want to show you. So this all the drop downs values are getting is coming from the database, right? So if you want to add more details in this drop downs, then there is no need to play with the code. Just put the information into the database and those values will come here, and the values will be rendered inside the drop down. So for each field I have created a table, and you need to enter the information in that table, and the information from the table will be rendered here, right? So this is the add student page. Again, I am going on the student. This is the student details. So means the information is coming from the database, and this is the data table. And if you want to sort, then just click on the title and the record will be getting sorted, right? So you can see records are getting sorted. Also, if you want to search the information, then you can search the information from here. So you can see the information are getting searched if you enter any of the information here, right? So this is the edit. So if you want to edit any of the information, then you can edit it and update it, right? And those information will be updated into the database. Okay, so again, student report. So this is the pagination. So if currently there are not more than 10 records, so if it's more than 10 records, then the pagination will come, and after that you can see more than one pagination here, means the next button will be 2, 3 and so on, right? You can see the showing one of three entries. You can see the information here. If you want to delete the information, just click on the delete and the information will be getting deleted from the database permanently, right? This is the change password from where admin will be able to change his password, and those password will be updated into the database directly, and you will not be able to log in with your old password. And for login, you need to enter your correct username as well as proper password. After that, you will be able to log inside the system. One more thing I want to show you, the above menu is totally dynamic. If you log out from the system, then the above menu will be hidden. Okay, so you can see the above menu is not coming. Means if you log inside the system, then above menu will be different. So it's coming according to the session. So if admin log inside the system, the different menus are coming. If admin log out from the system, the different menus are coming. So this is all about the project student information system. And as I told you earlier, this is a mini project developed in Python, Django and MySQL. So if you need more functionality in this project, just put it into the comment. I will incorporate those changes in this project and I will make this project according to your requirements. And don't forget to subscribe our channel for getting the latest video updates on the latest technologies. Thanks for watching the video. Thank you very much.